Hello, and welcome to Medicine with Dr. Moran. My name's Dr. Keith Moran. Much has been made about comorbidities and the risk of a more severe COVID-19 infection. But what do we actually know about the top comorbidities that lead to serious COVID-19 infection? I'm going to talk about this today. I find many patients tend to underestimate their risk, and they think that they're much healthier than they actually are. In my video, How to Tell If You're Healthy, I point out that 88% of Americans are actually not healthy. Through this pandemic, we've had a good idea of which comorbidities are the ones that are most likely to predict a poor outcome. This is a recent large study that I'd like to tell you about. It looks at almost 500,000 patients who were admitted with COVID-19. This study from the CDC was published this past week, and there's a link to the study in the description below for those who are interested. This is a large observational study where data from more than 800 hospitals in the United States were used looking at patients 18 years or older. All of these patients were admitted from April 1st, 2020 through March 31st, 2021. This data was obtained from the Premier Healthcare Database, as you can see on this slide. In total, there were 4,899,000 patients admitted to their database during these dates. Of these, 540,000 were hospitalized with COVID-19 infection, and out of those, 249 needed admission to the ICU or a step-down unit, with 76,000 requiring invasive mechanical ventilation, and 80,000 deaths in total. These patients were admitted to hospitals throughout the United States. This was the distribution of patients in the US. As you can see, they had large numbers of patients from different parts of the US. And also, if you look at the distribution of people from different ethnic and race backgrounds, they're pretty typical of what you would expect. Now for the results on the comorbidities. They found 18 comorbidities with a frequency of at least 10% or more in the patients that were studied. Here is the prevalence of each of the comorbidities. The most important, as one might guess, were high blood pressure, cholesterol abnormalities, obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. Less frequent comorbidities in this group of patients included esophageal disorders, which would include people with gastroesophageal reflux disease, or better known as heartburn. But there are also people with chronic kidney disease, anxiety disorders, COPD, which means smoking-related lung disease that we call emphysema, thyroid disorders, which is primarily underactive thyroid disease, depression, those also with implanted devices or grafts such as stents or pacemaker defibrillators. There are also problems with sleep, neurocognitive disorders, meaning dementia, diabetes, and asthma to round out the list of common comorbidities that were seen. Now, just because these comorbidities were present doesn't necessarily mean that it will lead to worse outcomes with COVID-19 infection. So the next step in their analysis was to look at who ended up in the ICU, who was ventilated, and who died. And of course, to see which comorbidities were associated with these outcomes. They put together two types of models, and really both models really showed similar results. They looked at each underlying frequent medical condition to see whether it was associated with death, ventilation, and ICU admission. First, I wanted to look at the frequent medical conditions that are not associated with death, ventilation, and ICU admission. This is the slide here. These comorbidities did not increase your risk. You can see that diabetes without complications, high blood pressure, cholesterol abnormalities, sleep disorders, esophageal disorders, depression, osteoarthritis were not associated with ICU admission, ventilation, and death. Their risk ratios were around 1, indicating no increased risk. Separately, they did find, though, that high blood pressure, if you're under 40 years of age, did predict death, ventilation, and ICU admission, even though it did not in other age groups. The risk of death was increased by 26% if you were under 40 with high blood pressure, to put it in perspective in this study. Now this slide shows the comorbidities that did predict ICU admission, ventilation, and death in the 18 to 39 years of age range, because I'm sure there's a lot of younger people that are interested to know what the comorbidities are. Obesity was the biggest risk factor in this age group, followed by diabetes, high blood pressure, as well as anxiety and fear-related disorders. On this next slide, we can see which comorbidities were associated with severe COVID-19 illness in all age groups. And the biggest risk factor was obesity. Other studies suggested the more obese someone is, the higher the risk actually is. So it's actually a gradation. For obesity, the risk ratio was 1.3 in their full model for death, which is the first column of this slide. This means the risk of death was 30% higher if you were obese. The risk if you had anxiety or fear-related disorders was 28% increased risk of death. Diabetes without complication, a 26% increased risk of death. The other relevant underlying medical conditions were neurocognitive disorders, such as the different kinds of dementia, chronic obstructive lung disease, which means emphysema, which of course is smoking related, a condition called aplastic anemia, coronary artery disease, as well as other heart disease, and rounding out the list was thyroid disorders. Now, the risk with thyroid disorders was relatively minimal, which was a 4% increased risk of death. Now, there's obviously some limitations given that this is an observational study. They use coding results from hospitalized charts, and some of the medical conditions may have been underestimated. For example, obesity in this study was seen in 33% of this group of patients, but the national prevalence is somewhere in the 45 to 50% range. Most importantly, because data was observational, you cannot always establish a causal association between the underlying condition and severe COVID-19 illness. In summary, based on this large observational study, 9 of 18 frequent underlying medical conditions among adults hospitalized with COVID-19 were associated with severe illness. The highest risk of severe COVID-19 was associated with obesity, anxiety and fear-related disorders, diabetes with complications, chronic kidney disease, as well as neurocognitive disorders, in other words, dementia. In patients younger than 40, high blood pressure was a significant risk factor for death as well. There's no question that each of these comorbidities can be improved with optimal medical care, which would reduce the risk of complications and improve the odds of patients surviving COVID-19 or any other illness that they may encounter through life. This is why it's important to make changes in your lifestyle and health to optimize these medical conditions. In other words, try to get healthy and then try to stay healthy. Thanks a lot for watching today on Medicine with Dr. Moran. My name's Dr. Keith Moran. Get healthy, stay healthy.